Tiffany was a part of that. Talk about the experience behind the scenes of working with Tiffany, and Tiffany, in turn, talk about working with your mentor.
Real husbands. Uh-oh. No, real husbands. Tiffany was it, because that was a talk we had. Tiffany, I got to hold the hands of these guys here. I don't need to hold your hands. So she was on her best behavior on that. I always like to tell the story. Tiffany's how I met Tiffany, and because we had the same agent at the time. And Jim and Shannon sent her to, we were doing a show called Who's Got Jokes. And they wanted her to have an audition. I said, of course, she can have an audition. Tiffany does an audition. Jim calls me up and says, how'd she do? I said, she was terrible. She's not going to be on the show. He says, please, Ralph, put her in the show. Please put her in the show. I said, okay, Jim. So I go over to Tiffany. I said, Tiffany, and I told her to her face, I said, only reason you're getting on the show is because we have the same agent, and you better be funny. And so we shoot the show, she wins the damn episode. She was so...
Because I had jokes, but I was taking a chance on the audition. Yeah, I shouldn't have did that. I should have came with the regular jokes that I had, but I was like, I got this really great... It was stupid.
But after that, Tiffany, and she will attest to this, I would hire her. Whatever I was doing, Tiffany was doing it with us because I knew she had the time.
Yeah, and I also follow directions.
Yes, you got
it. Yeah, you tell me, like, do this, do that. I'm like, okay, gotcha.
What are some memories that you have of working with Ralph on that project?
Which one? Because we worked on some projects. Okay, so.
It was all.
Let me tell you. Okay, so. Who got jokes? That audition was horrible. And I thought somebody else, I didn't know that who you were, that somebody else was you. And I was like, he told me he liked me. And then you came up and said, you were horrible. I was like, who are you? I'm not the problem. I was like, oh, I thought there was a light-skinned dude that liked me. Like, you better be funny, you better come with it, you better bring some real jokes, and better be funny. I was like, okay, not a problem. And I, like, pulled out, like, my real jokes and wrote some more and, like, got on stage every single night and came with it. And he was like, oh, okay, you can follow directions. And I was like, yep, you tell me what you need, I'm going to bring it. And so then Just Jordan, you started doing Just Jordan, right? And then I really needed a job. That was like in the homeless transition section. And then Jim called me again and said, Timmy, you need a job, man. Got me a job as a stand-in. And then I learned how to be around kids because I was like talking crazy. The kids would talk crazy, so I talk crazy to the kids.
Just telling them dirty jokes.
But the kids were telling me dirty jokes. That's not dirty